Good morning, friends. How is everyone today? It's Paris here from Mount Eliza. Tuesday the 15th of June, and it is a chilly, chilly day. As you can see, the sky is grey and the rest of it. I'll show you what the sky looks like up here. I'll turn the camera around. The sky looks clear. I think it's going to be a nice day. I think it's going to be nice, but it is still cold. It is still very, very cold. You can see all the, moisture on the tarps here. And another big day. It was a public holiday yesterday in Melbourne, friends, and all of Australia, I'm assuming. That's because, with the lockdowns and all that we've had in Australia, we haven't had enough days off. People haven't had enough days off. But see, these days off benefit the public servants who work for councils and anyone who works for government, because we've got to give them a break, right? We've got to give them a break. It's not enough. See, they're working from home. Most public servants are working from home, but they still need a day off, the poor things. They're very tired dealing with all this bureaucracy. I mean, it's very tiring on the brain, especially when you don't have much up here. So I should be inside running around with the birds. They're calling me already. But I've got to do some washing outside. I'm just, we've got some foliage here that I got on Saturday from the neighbours, as you can see. And this is half of it left, because the other half I dealt with. So I've got so much foliage here. You can see I've got a whole forest back here. So, and these are very heavy branches, very heavy. So good morning, darlings. Good morning, beautiful Emmy. Is that Emmy? Good morning, Emmy. They've chewed through to say hello. Good morning, Emmy. I've got to put another shade cloth. I just put a new one there 2 weeks ago. Hello, Emmy. Good morning. They're naughty, they chew things. Because they want little windows. I cover them up for the cold. They've got 2-3 layers of shade cloth here. Anyway, friends, so I was just, I don't know where those 3 days of the long weekend went. It was just quite crazy. And I don't know what you guys did. I hope you guys managed to achieve some kind of finish up or start some projects or do whatever. Now I'm just going to walk towards my outdoor kitchen. It's all right, babies, I won't be long. I'll be here soon. Now, friends, I was thinking of a few things. I was thinking of the terms distraction and the word anxiety. Because, you know, a lot of people come to me saying that they are anxious or their kids are anxious and all that. And I'm thinking, anxious about what? Anxious about what, friends? If you've got a roof over your head, you've got parents to feed you, right? You've got parents, right? If there are parents around with kids, the roof over their head, you've got warmth, you've got safety and security in a home. What on earth are the kids anxious about? Because it sounds to me like a referred behaviour pattern here. I think that kids are anxious, kids, teenagers, whatever. I think they're anxious. I'm just washing my organic celery here, in my second load now. I'm washing fruit for the birds. I think kids are anxious because parents are making them anxious. And the kids are finding the lockdowns as an excuse to say that they're anxious. Because, friends, I can't understand why kids are anxious if they have warmth, a roof over their head, food and parents. I don't get it. I really believe that the kids are finding that as an excuse for something else going in the family, in the household, that they cannot express or will not express. There may be incest. Right, there might be sexual abuse. Remember, it all happens in the family, in an extended family. There may be bullying from friends. There may be some kind of physical issue. It doesn't make sense to me why kids have got anxiety. The lockdown is not affecting anyone. I mean, they can still play in their backyards. They talk to their friends online and stuff. So what's the anxiety about? And let me ask you something else, friends. Well, I've got the celery here soaking in water. Let me ask you something else, friends. I'll just sit here with my lovely rosemary as a backdrop. You tell me, during the wars, during all the wars, How did children deal with anxiety then, hearing bombs above them fall, when they were young and their parents were killed? Right? And they had no parents, they were orphans, sent to orphanages. How did these kids deal with anxiety? These kids then grew up, who are now your grandparents and great-grandparents. How did they manage to survive, to live, to bring up their children, to work, have kids, grandkids? How did they manage their anxiety? We're calling this anxiety? Seriously? I mean, seriously, friends? Seriously, friends, you got kids and they got anxious. It's got nothing to do with the fucking lockdowns. It's because either you are imposing something on them or there's something in their direct environment. Because if your kids cannot handle stress that is out of their home, then you have not taught them how to, you have not socialized them in life. You have not taught them how to handle problems in life. What problems have kids got out there today? Nothing. Except I'm not talking about the ones that are sexually abused and homeless. I'm not talking about those kids. I'm talking about kids that have got a home, a roof over their head, and decent parents who aren't, of course, hitting them, abusing them, screaming at them, right? What stress, what anxiety. This is all bullshit. Kids have got anxiety. It's called spoiled brat syndrome. They can't go out when they want. They can't go where they want, where they want. It's called spoiled brat syndrome, right? Get real parents, get real friends. Anxiety is what our grandparents and great-grandparents and the rest went through during wars. Anxiety is what is going on in war countries now like Palestine and other countries all over the world that have been bombed on, drugged on, killed, murdered with drugs and stuff. That is anxiety, friends. Get real. Seriously, Australia's got to be the most spoon-fed sport country in the world. It's just, it just sickens me how we're only 200 years old. And children and adults are anxious about a lockdown that they're not opening their fat mouth to speak against. That's one thing. I know some of you may not want to hear it, tough. I'm not interested in those people. I'm talking about how a lot of kids and adults are using the excuse of anxiety of the lockdowns and all that. What do you mean? You can get out and walk. I'm not saying that the lockdowns are right. I'm not condoning them. But I'm saying we're not locked up in their houses. We're not locked up in their houses. They let you go out for shopping. They let you go out for walks. They let you go out. It's all wrong, all that, yes. But where's the anxiety? Why are people anxious? Like how were you living your life before that the lockdowns have impacted so much? I mean, like what were you doing before? Night clubbing every night that it impacted you, going to brothels every day that it impacted you. I don't get it. What I'm saying is, yes, these lockdowns are dictatorship, they're not right, but they should not cause mental health, because mental health is what our parents, grandparents and great-grandparents experienced during the wars. It's like I said, what the Palestinians are experiencing getting bombed at. It's what other countries that can't walk outside the house without being shot, whatever, from drug dealers and shit. That's where anxiety comes from. Australians generally have no reason to be anxious. Now, the other word that I was going to refer to, right, is dictatorship. Oh, so not dictatorship, is a distractions. You know what a distraction is, friends? A distraction is when you want to walk somewhere, or you want to do something. You want to go somewhere physically, you want to do something. And you've got something stopping in your way. So you've got something ahead of you stopping you. So that thing ahead of you could be something tangible, something you can feel, or someone. Or it might be something psychological, like a fear, right? So what's happened is, I'm just rinsing the celeries out. So what's happened is these distractions, aren't they just to stop you from doing things at the here and now? They also stop you from pursuing any action in the near future, whether it's, you know, in a day, a month, a year, 10 years or whatever. Now, these distractions can be obvious, Well, that cannot be obvious, right? So the word distraction is not a little thing, it's a big word. So for instance, I might be telling you now, friends, go and meditate, and I'm just saying an example, right? Go and meditate, go get your crystals out, go get your singing bowls out, go, you know, sit there and meditate and whatever to, I don't know, to find yourself, to you know, have some inner peace, calm or whatever, right? By the way, you can do that sitting next to a tree too. You don't have to sit cross-legged to go and have some peace, right? And then, so while I tell you that, I can then turn around and say, now I need to sell, I'm just saying an example, I'm not doing this. Now friends, go and do that. But also, I can't work. This is an example I'm saying now. I can't work, I can't go out there and earn any money. So I'm selling hemp, and I'm selling hats, and I'm selling t-shirts, right? Because I can't go out there and earn money. And this is the only way that I can earn money is by selling hemp, H-E-M-P, and caps and t-shirts, right? Because I can't go out there and work. I'm just saying an example. That is a distraction person. Because what they do is, these people, is they tell you what you want to hear. You know, go meditate, find yourself, find some peace and calm. And then they spin some bullshit on the side to manipulate you. So you trust them because they tell you, oh, you know, find yourself and have some peace. So that person and that group is a distraction. They're telling you what you want to hear. And then on the side, they're saying we need money. You need to find out what they're doing with that money. You need to find out why can't they work? Why is it a lot of other people can work? Why can't someone who is healthy and has got half a brain, why can't they go out and work? Because they don't want to work. Because they want to live off your money. These distractions are out there for you to assume. I've got another good distraction too, especially in Australia. These distractions exist so that you can be complacent about what you really need to do in order for us to get out of this dictatorship that we're in on this planet. Another distraction is these groups who last year popped up like mushrooms. I'm talking about the Australian online groups that I got sucked into too, teaching us about Magna Carta and common law and the rest of it. And I was saying to within a year, we have no rights. As soon as the state of emergency got in, and now state of emergency is going to be phased out slowly this year, and we're going to go into a pandemic law, right? Because we're all screaming against the state of emergency. And then when we're screaming about the pandemic law for another 1 year, then they're going to find another law and another law and another law until we're all disintegrated and we don't exist anymore. Right? So what these groups did last year and are still doing, they are telling Australians and people in Canada and over the world, all over the world, that we've got to push for our basic rights and that we have this Magna Carta right and we have this right and that right and whatever, and write letters to the government and write letters to this and write letters to that person. That's a distraction. Because in my experience, writing letters to government, and in millions of, and thousands of people and millions across the globe have written letters to government, and we all know, most of them, they get nowhere. The only way you can get anything done from the government is to do under-the-table deals. I'm not talking sex. Under-the-table cash deals. Right? They'll give me a job if I say what they want me to say. Friends, you got to understand that all these letters that are circulating, as in we the undersigned, you know, are saying that the governments are imposing on our civil rights and our human rights and all that, they are all bullshit. They're not applicable. Do you understand that? We have no common rights. We have no common human rights. We don't have any rights. We never had rights. We never really had rights. If there was any justice in the legal system anywhere else, it's only because there was a good judge who was able to empathise and to have some compassion towards the case that we were presenting. So all these groups that are saying to you all that we have rights are a distraction, are telling you all these things. So you can think that by writing to governments, writing to associations, groups or whatever, that they're going to listen to us. They're not listening to us. They didn't listen to us in 2020. They didn't listen to us before that, when people like myself and others were writing to these organisations and governments for human rights, animal rights, nature rights and the rest of it. They weren't listening. So why should they listen now? Why should they listen now when they are pretty much halfway, when the elite are pretty much halfway, if not further in, into their plans? So what's happened is the governments are enforcing all their plans, everything they want to do about this, patches, this and the rest of it, and lockdowns and all that. They're doing all that, right? Because we have been distracted by 99.999% of all the online groups in Australia and all over the world who are making you believe that they have your interests at heart and that you have rights, because they are all the not-so-obvious establishment that controlled opposition. They are a distraction. That is a big word that you need to start learning, because we all need to start observing and paying attention to who is a distraction out there. All political parties are distractions to make you believe that they're sticking up for us or that they will stick up for us. Film producers, people here and there who've done films and all that, they're all distractions. Look at their court hearings. Look at their court hearings. Some of you saying, oh, but this and this such person has got court cases. Follow the court cases, read the court cases, and look at what they're presenting. It's all bullshit. They're not presented professionally and properly because they don't want to win the cases. They do not want to win the cases. They are only creating these legal cases so that they can fundraise, and they're getting millions and millions. This is why they're creating these legal cases. They're not serious. They're not serious. And a lot of you are still following these distractors because you have not made the time to research exactly who is who and why they're doing what they're doing. Like, someone is speaking like me. I'm speaking. Why am I saying what I'm saying? You know, you're not asking these questions. Why? Because you think that life is going to go back to how your life is going to go back to how it was. Game over, friends. Game over. Don't even bother wasting your time and money on setting up new businesses and all that. It's not worth it. Work from home if you can. Work from home. It's not going to work. Or get a place with the cheapest rent, the lowest rent, and make sure your contracts are really safe. Because landlords are going to look after their own pockets. They have to. They've got mortgages to pay on their commercial and residential properties. They don't have time to be... They're not a charity. Being a landlord is not a charity. We've got mortgages to pay on our assets, on the properties. So don't even waste your time and money sending your kids here and there, learning this and that. There's no jobs. There's going to be no jobs. The way things are right now, there's going to be no jobs. Life is not going to be how it was before. I don't understand why a lot of you think we're going to go back to normal. The government has been telling us for over a year in the news. The governments have been telling us we have to get used to a new normal. And that new normal means we're not going to have a normal life. Well, there wasn't a normal life before, let alone now. So I don't know why a lot of you think that you can go back to setting up your lives as if there's nothing wrong. So, the two words, anxiety and distractions. There's no need for Australians to have anxiety unless you're homeless, physical illnesses, abuse, domestic emotional abuse, and physical issues, right? There's no need to have anxiety. And like I said, kids having anxiety, look at their environment. It's the same as with animals and birds. When birds are anxious, the first thing I tell the owners is, what have you fed them? What are they eating? And what is their direct environment and what medical issues? Same with people. If you're feeling anxious and stressed, what are you eating? You're having a lot of sugar, you're having junk food, are you having crap foods? What are your medical issues? Have you done blood tests? Have you looked at if you've got any health issues that are upsetting your body and they're coming out emotionally? And third, your environment. Have you got mold around? Have you got an abusive partner? Have you got abusive kids? Have you got, like, have you got noise in the areas? What's stressing you out? Environment, medical, and food. It's that basic. Environment, medical, food. it's that basic to deal with anxiety issues. Environment, medical, and food. It doesn't get more complicated than that. You don't need any gurus or experts out there or to do meditation for years to figure out where your anxiety is coming from. Environment, medical and foods. And medical includes also what medications you're on. If you're taking medications, of course they're gonna stuff up, they're gonna mess with your whole physical, natural chemical, your natural chemistry, right? So that causes all these issues. So look out for distractors and distractions, because this is what we have. Anyway, I'll keep repeating in all my videos, if you wanna join our movement in Australia, I've got the Facebook page, Dr. Shiva Australia Members. Join our movement of truth, freedom and health. It is real truth, real freedom and real health. Because without truth, freedom and health, you got nothing. A lot of you may think, oh, I've got health. Well, look again. Right? How healthy are you really? Just because you can stand there, just because you're young in your 30s and 40s. You think you're healthy, everything starts coming up, 50s and 60s. And with all the distractions that we have in our life, and it's going to get even worse this year. And I said last year, it's going to get really, really bad. Really, really bad. We have to save ourselves. We have to help ourselves. Without truth, we can't have freedom. We can't have health. Without freedom, we can't have health. We can't have truth. And without health, you got nothing. That health, you're laying in bed, you're sick, you can't move. You don't have the energy to do anything else, friends. That's why I say it's really, really important what you consume. Really, really important what you consume. Anyway, I'll put the link up of the Dr. Shiva Australia members group page where you can be a general member or you can be a warrior member. I'm looking for more warrior admins for this page. And we're going to be all over social media. And all over any media that we can. And there's a lot of information about health. It's all videos, a lot of information. You can just have the video playing while you're doing your work or whatever, right? A lot of videos so you can strengthen your immune system, because that is one thing that the medical industry, I'm disgusted with the medicos in Australia. Not one person is saying publicly, come out publicly, to say how to strengthen our immune system. I cannot believe it, that they'll push pharmaceuticals, but no GPs or specialists have come out to say, now make sure you eat this and that publicly. They're not doing it publicly. They might be doing it amongst their own groups, very quietly, but why haven't they approached the government and said, hey, if this bug really does exist, we need to strengthen people's immune systems. Why isn't anyone saying that? Oh, they're too scared of their jobs. Well, I tell you something, medical industry. You're not going to have much of a clinic or a business if people stop trusting you guys. And if people can't afford proper healthcare, because the government's going to stop all healthcare, friends. Remember me. There won't be any public hospitals, there won't be any Medicare, there won't be any pensions, there won't be any superannuation. Everything's going to be cut back. It's already cut back now. I mean, you try and get into the system, how long do you have to wait in the public system? That's how it used to be in Greece in the 70s under the dictatorship. You had to pay doctors in Greece and in Italy, you still do, for them to you know, the fuck you're lucky, the little envelope with cash in it. That's been going on for decades in Greece. If you want any proper health care in the hospitals, you had to pay them off. I'm sure it still happens. Well, that's what's going to be happening here. And if you've got no money, you can't pay off anyone for any health care. You get that, friends? It's happening now. Go to the hospitals. You can't get any. Right? I know it's a fact. I have a friend of mine who went into the hospital and he said there were at least, I think he said over 20, 30 ambulances waiting at the ramp at a public hospital. And the ambulance drivers that are actually signing in the patients, where is the staff? Where are the nurses to sign in the patients? Where are the nurses to get the patients from the ambulance, from the back of the ambulance, and to sign them in. Where are they? Nowhere. We don't have a health system in Australia or anywhere in the world. You don't have a lot of money to pay off people, and if you don't have a lot of money, and if you don't have contacts in the health industry, we're not going to have any public. Forget it. You really think with everything that you know, do you really think that they want our health to improve? And the best way for our health not to improve is for us to have no healthcare. We're not going to have any healthcare. I know from personal experience. I've spent over $250,000 on healthcare over the past 20 years. There's no healthcare out there. I had to find the medical medium 2 years ago to learn about Epstein-Barr virus and the herpes virus and everything else that we all have to learn why my body was in havoc for 20 years. There's no healthcare out there. I've been to naturopaths, chiropractors. I've been everywhere. I've even done Chinese medicine. It didn't work on me, the acupuncture. I'm not saying it doesn't work on others. Philip does it. He says it works on him. My dad, it does, because he's still limping, right? But our bodies has got so much toxicity in them that these natural stuff, well, if you're very, very ill, like I have been for many years, and you've got a lot of toxicity in your body, emotional and physical and the rest of it, right? Naturopathic stuff and acupuncture and that won't work. Chiropractic won't work. Nothing will work. I mean, you can't touch me like this without me saying, ouch, from the pain that I have. Yeah, I've got the physical strength to do what I'm doing. It's because I'm having the certain foods and vitamins that I need to have. I couldn't move. I could not move. I know what paralysis means. I could not move. And as I said, as you get 50 plus, things are going to get worse. Your health starts changing from 30. The body has changes, natural changes. You can't avoid them. Then from 40, 45, 50 and onwards. Right, we're not going to have any healthcare. We've got to start looking after ourselves. We've got to start looking after. I'm not giving any medical advice. I'm just saying that even medications that you take, have you researched medical journals like I do online to see what impact these medications have on your liver and your kidneys and your spleen? Have you seen that? Because you've got to remember that doctors, GPs are not nutritionists. GPs are not, they don't know about vitamins and that. They don't get paid from the vitamin companies to tell you these things. They get paid from the pharmaceuticals to tell you this stuff. We've got to become our own doctors. I've been hearing that for many years from my family. We've got to become our own doctors. We've got to look after ourselves. Because no one else will. When you're very sick and you can't go into the hospital and you're waiting and you're waiting. And in the meantime, while you're waiting, your injuries are getting worse. And your injuries are getting worse. What are you going to do? You're going to just sit there twiddly-dee, twiddly-dum, waiting for someone to tell you how to help yourself? No, you get on your B12 liquid, you get on your zinc, you get on your lemongrass, your lemon balm, you get on all your vitamins that I've been posting on for the past year plus. Past year, it's been our year that I've been doing lives. You start taking all that stuff, your turmeric, right? Your licorice root. You start taking all this stuff to strengthen your immune system, your fruits and your veggies. You start taking all this stuff, you see the difference. Because I've done it, and I see now that I can talk, I can move. I couldn't before, I was struggling a lot. I was struggling. And friends, I do at least 5 full-time jobs in one day, every day, at least, right? I've got 50 projects on the go, all at once. Yeah, I'm full on, I've been like this all my life, but I've been more now, because I've got the parrots, right? So with the parrots, my parrot family comes also, the responsibilities, going to farms, washing veggies, doing, you know, cooking for them, cleaning, maintaining them, caring for them when they're not well, if they have an injury, if they fly or something happens, helping other people with animals. You saw the trees at the start that I showed, I carried all those. I shouldn't be walking. I'm not meant to be walking. I'm not meant to be walking. I've had professionals tell me that if I keep going like this, in a couple of years I'm finished. Well, I know that as a fact because I couldn't walk. It's been 3-4 years. I went to osteopaths and everyone, and that's all the bullshit. The osteopath said to me, it's normal to have foot injuries. It's normal to have foot injuries. I wasted a whole year of money and time. It's normal to have foot injuries. I trusted them. I don't trust them anymore. There's just very few people now. I'm very hard who I trust. So I shouldn't even be on my feet. But I'm not going to sit about doing nothing. I take my vitamins instead. I load up, like I said, with my turmeric, the curcumin. I've got all my vitamins. Anyway, friends, I just wanted to say good morning. That's it. I know it was serious topics. Well, we're dealing with serious stuff in life at the moment. The sun may be out. It's going to be out today. It's going to be beautiful. But it doesn't mean that we should ignore the reality of our world at the moment. June 15, 2021, we are under a world dictatorship, right? And Australia doesn't have it as bad as, for instance, countries like Greece. They have to have this. Have to. The kids can't go to school if the parents don't do it. If you work, you have to have it. I know this firsthand. I know this from a friend I have overseas. Right? They tell me everything. They have to. So that's where we're going to get in Australia. And if we accept it, then we're fucking idiots. Then we're absolute fucking idiots. Careful of distracted friends. All those groups online who are pretending to, who are doing your protests, petitions and the rest of it, they're all distractors. They're all distractors. They're not doing anything. They're doing this stuff, working for the government, for the political parties, whether it's Liberal or Labor. Same with the Animal Justice Party. It's really the Labor Party and the Greens and Fiona Patton. That's what they have gone. Can you believe that these three parties have agreed for Australia, for Victoria, to have a state of emergency? So they don't care whether people work or not. They don't care whether people have money. The Animal Justice Party, the Greens and Fiona Patton, they don't want you to have money to feed your family, feed yourself, your family and your pets. Because that's what state of emergency is. You can't work. A lot of people can't work. They don't want you to look after your animals. They don't want you to look after nature. Like with, I know a lot of people who, with their own money, they feed possums and they care for nature and all that, right? And they build veggie gardens for the possums and for the wild animals. These groups, the Greens, Animal Justice Party and Fiona Patton, Fiona Patton got away by, you know, the brothels are allowed to be open in regional Victoria. They don't care about anyone because they all have jobs, you see. They all have money. They all have jobs and they all have money. They've been bought out. They have black souls. They have black souls who've been brought out. They've been all bought out from the government. They don't care for you to live. We're letting those rotten scumbag political parties dictate your life, my life. Think about it. Animal Justice Party, the Greens, and Fiona Patton is telling you what to do. They're all uneducated. They're telling you how to live. Is your head spinning? They're telling you how to live. What to do, when to, where to go, when to go, how to go, what to do and everything. Tell me something else though. If it wasn't those three political parties supporting Dan Andrews, the Labor government and the Liberal, it'd be other political parties. But what the government did was, is they got three, they are using three minority independent parties, right? They're using them. The government is using them so that when something bad happens, the government is going to say, well, it's not just our fault, it's also those parties' fault. They supported the state of emergency bill. See, that's what politicians do. They use people and they exploit people. And these dumbass political groups think that by supporting the state of emergency bill that's going on, that the government is going to give them, is going to pass through some laws that they want. Animals are still getting murdered all the time. The Labor Party is giving permits to everyone and anyone to kill parrots, kangaroos, and anyone else. And yet the Animal Justice Party is still voting and still sleeping and in bed with Dan Andrews. Can you see, friends, that these corrupt assholes are controlling your life? And you're letting them. What can I say? Anyway, I've got to get back to my celery. I'm washing it a few times. It's from the farms. It's organic celery. I'm just letting it just soak a bit because I've got to get rid of the debris. All food has to be washed well, whether it's from your garden or not. All of it, right? It's unbelievable, friends. It's unbelievable how many black souls expose themselves online. And unfortunately, a lot of these black souls are nurses, disability carers. They're in the helping professions. And they show who they really are on social media. On all platforms, not just Facebook, on all platforms. This world is fucked. And we have got the wrong people working in helping in health in professions. Like, who would want to go in aged care? I mean, you'd have rocks in your head to go in aged care. Why would you send your loved ones to aged care? Why? I mean, we know what goes on, right? The abuse, lack of vitamin, food and all that. Why? Why would you? Why? What happened decades ago when people used to look after their parents at home? Why can't kids do that now? I mean, if your parents cared for you and were good with you, why do you want to send them off? They cared for us. Yeah, they cared for you, right? So why would you want to send them away? Why? You're going to have no holidays. You're going to have no quality of life. You might as well have your mum and dad around to help you if they can. Help one another. Anyway, friends, this is just one batch of celery here that I've got. Just one batch of the organic celery. And it's still cold. I've got to run in because the birds are going to be screaming where I am. They're not going to be happy that I'm not in there doing what I need to do every morning. I've been up very early from the dark hours. Join our Australian movement, which is Dr. Shiva's movement in America, in Massachusetts there. And I've set up the group here in Australia online on Facebook and also on Instagram. And we'll be going wider online. So we'd love to see you there as members, free or paid, up to you. That's okay. Have a great Tuesday morning. The sun is coming out. It's going to be a lovely sunny day in Melbourne. It's going to be beautiful. Makes my work a bit easier. And at least the poor birds and animals out there won't be suffering so much in nasty weather. All right, everyone. Thanks for listening. I love you all. And high vibrations. Bye, everyone.